Dog,
we lit,
what is
we
wrong
lit.
With these niggas, man? What is what? Wrong with these niggas, man?
What did Perkins say?
hey, not even Perkins. Big Baby.
Oh, Glenn Davis said it.
Glenn Davis tweeted to Kyrie, nigga. As soon as they announced, yo, Kyrie's not coming back to the game on Sunday, Big Baby go talk about, hey, that's the same ankle you used to stomp on Lucky. Oh, well. Karma's a bitch.
Hey.
Nigga said the same ankle you used to stomp on Lucky. Niggas, how dare you? That's hilarious, bro. These niggas are sick.
Niggas is preying on people's downfall. That's crazy.
Yeah, man.
That's wild. That's funny, though. That's funny as fuck.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
I wasn't expecting Perkins to get that. I mean, Big Baby to get that off.
Yeah.
That would have been something I thought that was gonna be Perk.
You feel me? Or KG was going, you feel me, throw something out there, you know what I'm saying? Cause he felt the way we should all do better. Like, nigga, all of us, nigga. The fuck? Yeah. me included, nigga, I ain't got nothing to do with this shit. Kyrie said,
nigga. I ain't no Celtic, nigga. They just traded me there.
You got me fucked up, nigga.
Bang.
Got me fucked up.
Right, nigga. I ain't no motherfucking Celtic, nigga. The fuck, right. Nigga? Nigga, I'm in Brooklyn, bitch ass nigga. Where the money reside, nigga?
Where the money reside?
Hey, that's what I'm trying to get.
All right, you know
where
what?
I've
been playing around doing that too much lately.
You been fucking it up lately.
I've been fucking it up.
Hey, that's all right. You just been living your best life. Summer back open, dog. You know what I'm saying? Like the world back open. You trying to get turned up. You trying to get caught up from last year. I feel it.
Yeah, man. TTU. Too turned up gang. You feel me?
Too turned up gang. You know what I'm saying? TTUG.
Yeah, all that shit.
T-Tug. No,
I ain't tugging nothing. Look,
you're not tugging nothing.
Nah, man, I'm tugging your bitch.
Hey, you feel me? You could have.
I got this blue, no blue though. You feel me? It was blue, but now it's Pinot. You feel me?
Yeah, blue, no blue. I like that. Coming soon, blue, no blue. Heard it here.
Ooh, that's kind of hard. Blue, no blue.
Yeah, that's kind of hard. Yeah.
Hey, man.
Yeah, you heard it.
That's where my joints at? Where my joints at? Here we go.
Okay, there we go. Oh, wait. There we go. We got some gunshots.
That wasn't it.
Take a gunshot? Okay, now I feel safe.
Bang, bang. Bang.
That's what I told. I did an interview the other day. That's what I told the nigga. You feel me? I let off a couple gunshots and an air horn. I was like, you feel me? This my neighborhood right here.
I was like,
you know, a couple gunshots. You feel me? You hit the train tracks. You feel me? Box shifts, slide, something like that. You feel me? Like, nah, y'all niggas don't know.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah. People think gunshots just mean it's a bad neighborhood. Nah. It just really means we're trying to keep the gentrification away. You know what I'm saying? You gotta let off a few gunshots every now and then. Keep the gentrification
away. Every now and again, you feel me?
Yeah.
You know, Sally Mary May Sue, nigga. You feel me?
They're just gonna look in the newspaper and always see, like, damn, like, once a week, it's like gunshots over in that neighborhood.
Once a week, nigga. But this bitch off, nigga, Tuesdays and Thursdays.
Okay.
Tuesdays and Thursdays, 11:13 p.m., nigga. So it's not it can't be like a regular time, you feel me?
Yeah, it gotta be something off. Some off-brand hour.
Yeah. 10:42, you feel me? All we heard down the block was, damn, now all of a sudden that, fucking, Millhouse and Johnson, manufacturing construction company group don't want to come in and build new fucking apartments. Yeah. Goddamn.
Yeah, nah, they trying to stay out. Everybody's trying to stay away. Nigga, rent just dropped.
Yeah, man. And on top of that, nigga, the rent is still too damn high.
Right. And that is ever worse. Sensational.
Big facts, man. You feel me? Hey, yeah, you're now tuned into the motherfucking greatest, the Sensational Sheep Show. You feel me?
The Talk Sensational about episode Sheep Show.
76. You feel me? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You feel me? Triple S. You feel me? In the motherfucking building. Y'all talking about? You feel me? This is episode number 76. I go by the name of Graham. You feel me? To the left of me right there. That's my mans. You feel me? It's YR the Goldmine. And we are... We are the two black sheep, man. Hey, nah, nigga, hold on, nigga. Why my shit say two black Simba, nigga? I am, oh my God, Graham. I don't like that. Hold on. Why, hey, while I fix this, Goldmine. Tell them what they info.
Oh yes. But before I give you guys a rundown, let me tell you where you guys can follow us. You guys can follow us at two black sheep _ on Twitter, or at two black sheep on Instagrams. Or you can go to youtube.com/twoblacksheep. And yours now says Simba. Yep. But his name is not Simba, everybody. You already know. It's at Oh My God Graham. That is him. And I am Mr. It's YR the Goldmine. If y'all trying to find us on social media, if y'all trying to talk shit to us on social media, pull up, nigga. We ain't ducking no smoke.
Not at all.
We ain't ducking no smoke.
I want Graham all the smoke. I want Graham all the smoke.
Graham, you on a smoke break?
I want all the smoke, nigga.
He said, nah. He said he in Newport factory. Nah, but this week, what we talking about? We talking about... Okay. Nah, so on the agenda, on the agendas, we talking about... We got a new project from the Migos we gonna review. We got a new project from Polo that we finna review. You know what I'm saying? We got a couple singles that we gonna talk about. We got one in particular from Meg we're gonna run through. We gonna chop it up about what the fuck is going on with Kanye and his ex-in-laws. All these celebrity boxings and who finna get faded and blended next. James Harden out here tricking. His bag is big with it too.
Big bag.
And you know, we're gonna cover Big Birkin. And we're gonna cover the man Simba. If y'all don't know, y'all need to get to know. In our get to know segment. You know what I'm saying?
You feel
so,
me.
Yeah, you feel
you're a
me.
Fucking nut, nigga.
But before we get into all that, Mr. Graham.
Yes, sir.
Let me ask you. Because I feel like this is vital. To not just our friendship, you know, because a lot of friends be going through rifts nowadays. But I need to ask you, how are you doing? How is everything going with you? How's your mental? How's your mind state? Are you mad at your
friend? I'm well. I am totally irritated at you right now. I can't believe you for the life of me. Yeah,
where did I get
on this? I don't know, man. No, I'm good, man. I'm good. It's been a really good week. If I could be honest with you, it's been a really, really good week. Since we've been here, Of course. I usually don't, but I did get some sleep. I got a little extra little side hustle popping off too, with a couple little extra dollars coming in. You feel me? So that's Gucci. I'm not
legal,
mad at that.
Legal? Hey, not my business. Let's just keep going.
Doesn't matter, does it? Not at all. Anyways, the week's been good though. Definitely got some spend some time with the kid. You feel me? Run around. She swindled me out some money. You feel me? Some cool things going on. You feel me? Like I said, a couple little side hustles popping off. You know what I'm saying? Little passive income. You feel me? Shit like that. Other than that, man, I'm just chilling. Trying to. I'll leave that alone. But how are you?
We like passive income.
Yeah, you feel me? How are you? How's your mental health? Are you mad at me for anything? Is there anything that I can do to help you with anything, sir?
I'm in the words of Future, sensational.
Sensational. You know what I mean?
Sensational.
Yeah. That's how I'm doing. No, I'm pretty good. If I could echo what you're saying, I had a pretty solid week. You know what I mean? No complaints on my side. I don't have any new hustles.
Nah. Tell that bitch you ain't got no passive income, but you got massive income, bitch.
Yeah. I ain't got the passive, but I got the massive, you know what I'm saying? But I told the bitch she could, I need that passive income. You know what I mean? Ooh. I mean, where it come in, you pass it over here. Yeah, you know I'm talking about.
Yeah. I don't need that ask it income. You feel me? Don't ask me for shit. Big action, Bronson, man. That is hilarious.
Yeah, man.
Fuck, that's delicious.
Yeah. I am pleased to say that a lot of my summer plans are turning up and they're not being canceled. This time last year, all my summer plans were
everything
canceled. So like I feel good and we have some summer music to accompany.
Yeah, we do.
The summer, you know.
The sunshine.
Good couple releases that came out. Shout out to Lil Flip. Yeah, the sunshine. We had a project from Migos, a project from Polo. We had a new summer banger that dropped from Tyga. St. John dropped a track with SZA for the
Space Jam, right?
Space Jam soundtrack. Yes.
Yes, sir. Pierre
Bourne also dropped a project. And a few more people, you know what I mean? It was a pretty loaded album week.
It was. We got some really good music this week, and you know what? I'm all here for it. Little baby golf clap.
Yes. let's get into some albums, man. Let's get into some music.
That's what we here for, dog. We got some good music this week. I ain't even mad. Last week was Gucci, you feel me? And this week we got a double, triple shot, you feel me? Some cool records, man. We're going to start with the Migos, of course. Culture 3.
With our friends.
Long-waited and anticipated. Since this show has began, the Migos have been on the clock.
Mm-hmm. Me personally, I put them on the clock. I will admit that I've been the person that's been counting down, holding the buzzer, you know, like pressing the buzzer over and over every week. Mm-hmm. Like,
let niggas know, you feel me?
These niggas is done. Like take them out the oven. Like,
oh man, put a fork in them, right? You feel me?
Yeah. I'll be the first to admit that. Like, their last album was a little underwhelming. So
it was.
And then from being. From going to that to their solo projects to having such a long hiatus between them putting out music and Culture One, which was the last really good project, my expectations were low. I'll keep it lit. That's why I kept putting the meat thermometer in there and was like, oh man, these motherfuckers is cooked, dog. Like, you know what I mean? But.
But what? It sounds like is the apology gonna be as loud as the disrespect?
I was wrong, man. It wasn't cooked, dog. I thought they was cooked, dog.
Oh, we thought they was cooked.
Man, I can admit what I'm wrong. I can admit what I'm wrong. I had to learn. You know, bitches don't like to think I can admit what I'm wrong.
He got cooked.
So you got cooked.
I got cooked. Put this on the record right now. I'm apologizing for being wrong. You know what I mean? So all them bitches out there that be like, I can't ever be wrong. I'm wrong. You know what I mean? It's noted. It's documented now. You know what I'm saying? But I like this project a lot. Actually, like. I don't know though. I could be biased because I ain't been outside in a while. You know what I mean? But outside, back open. But
maybe you had that music where it's like, you feel me? Like you feeling like, all right, I'm finna be outside. Like, is this music gonna be worth it within the next month and a half or so when shit really get to popping off? My answer is gonna be yes.
What are your initial thoughts? Yeah. You got any initial thoughts on this?
My initial thoughts on the album. Before we break into it, my initial thoughts on the album. I ran through it. You feel me? I didn't run through it on Thursday night, but I ran through it on Friday. And it was cool, but it wasn't really him. And that was me being distracted and trying to do a bunch of other shit. But I gave this motherfucker the whip test.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you, my friend. Hey, cause this shit right here. They didn't have to do this shit.
Whoa.
They didn't have to do this shit. They didn't have to do this shit. Roadrunner go crazy.
Yeah.
Hey, this is a pretty good album. This is a pretty good album. Once I gave this motherfucker the whip test, and then I ran through it again after that, and I was like, okay. I don't know if we could say they on the clock no more, my G. I don't know. But they took time with this. They took their time with this, you feel me? And this is a good product. So shout out to the Migos. What was your initial response or reaction to the record when you first heard it?
When I first heard it, to be honest, I listened to the first 5 songs and turned it off. That was my initial reaction. I was kind of like you said, when I originally put it on, it was Friday. I was a little distracted. I was just like, let me just play something just to hear something, right? Avalanche comes on immediately. Like, there's no intro to the song. There's no nothing. It just immediately comes on. It's like the baby songs. Comes that on didn't matter and just to me. somebody starts snapping. No, it caught me off guard because I was just like, oh, okay, they're coming in right there and like going.
Yeah. At home all alone, hustling, trying to keep this shit together.
Yeah, exactly. So you start off like that and I was like, okay, and then the beat dropping, niggas is going. I'm like, oh, all right. And so it woke my game up a little bit, you know, it caught me off guard. And so it went into Having Our Way, which I happened to hear first. I heard that on Thursday, just happened to hear that at night and out just because it was out. And I was like, let me just hear what the strike track is. And then I was like, all right. And then I already heard Straightening. So I kind of like skipped those two a little bit.
Hey, face. What? Hey, shit done changed. They and talk to me different when they see my paste from Lucian Grange. Told myself that I would get through this verse and I'm not gonna mention the plane.
Right.
But look at the plane.
That nigga said I told myself I'm gonna get through this verse and not mention the plane.
Yeah.
But look at the plane, nigga.
Yeah, he be
I'm sick of this nigga, man.
I got through the first 5 and I just realized like I really gotta listen to it. And that's why I turned it off. And I did what you did too. I took it in the whip. I took it on the spin test. And boy, that changed the whole perception of everything. I already liked it, but I was just like, oh yeah, this is outside. This is outside, outside. I feel it.
Yeah,
like,
this is for sure outside music. Shout out to the Migos, definitely. I fucked with Straightening as soon as they dropped that right off top. Mm-hmm. You feel me? I fucked with I Need It too when that record first dropped. But it was just those first couple of records that they dropped last year that kind of was like, I don't know where they're going with this, but from what we got from Culture 2, you know what I'm saying? It was cool, but it wasn't peak Migos. You feel me? It wasn't them at their best. So like you said, for them to go from that to into their solos, which were all subpar, you feel me, to them coming back to this, to saying, okay, where are they on the totem pole for, you know what I'm saying, hot niggas or whatever, you feel me? The niggas, because they set trends. They are the reason why a lot of niggas are rapping the way that they rapping, you feel me, and all the shit. So just giving them that respect of shit, giving it the whip test, I had to do that. I had to.
Yeah. Yeah. Avalanche was a standout to me. Straightening, of course. To be honest, Having Our Way is one of my least favorite songs on the project.
It's funny that you say that. I damn near feel the same way. It's a good song, but I'm like, there's other songs that I would rather play before that.
Yeah, and it doesn't fit the vibe of the the vibe of the album to me that much. Like, it has, it just has a different, it has like a darker bop to it than the rest of the album. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. But I like Type Shit. Offset floated on that, probably because his wife was on there, so he decided to show his ass off, but
Offset floated on a lot of this shit.
Yeah, so to take off, I could have did a lot without Quavo, to be honest, but I know why Quavo's there. I like Malibu. I like Malibu a lot. Birthday is a hit. Birthday is a hit for sure. Vaccines. I didn't like Vaccine the first listen, and then I liked it. And I really like Picasso with Future. I like all of these, to be honest. Roadrunner's a hit. When You See
Super Hard
and Jane Go Crazy. That's that. Takeoff one with the Birkin thing.
Oh, that's really the Birkin that record.
She needed a Birkin.
She wanted a Birkin. I thought yeah, that song was called Jane, wasn't it?
Yeah, that shit go crazy.
Why was that song called Jane?
I have no idea, but I like that song.
I have no idea why that song was called Jane.
And I always like Takeoff hooks. I don't know why. But Takeoff do good. Antisocial was cool. It's cool to hear Juice WRLD. And I like Light It Up because that sounded like they did that before Pop Smoke passed.
I think that they did. You feel me? Because Quavo, of course, was doing a lot of work with Pop Smoke at the time. And on top of that, if you go to youtube.com/twoblacksheep, there is a video of the Migos and Quavo previewing new records. This was last summer, before Culture 3 came out, and these records, some of them did make the album. However, some of them did not. So I would say go check that out. I'll tweet it or something like that in you know, association with this episode or something. But yeah, check out that youtube.com/twoblacksheep, where you should be watching this right now. So if you're listening to this, make sure you subscribe to youtube.com/twoblacksheep if you have not already.
Whatever.
If you have subscribe to that, of course. Like my man's just said on that side, hit that bell for the Noti Gang so you know when we go live and all that there.
Yeah. But closing out my review on this album, I really liked it. I really liked it. I appreciated the length of the album a lot. It seems like everybody's got out of everybody's got out the quick album mode. Lately, we've been getting a lot of 17, 18.
Because the thing with that was when this whole streaming wave first started, it was kind of like everybody was giving us the longer albums, and then they started shortening. Because if you look back at Culture 2 had like 23 songs on it. It was hella songs on Culture 2. It was hella songs on that album. Unnecessarily so, but it was hella songs on that album. A lot of them. A lot of unnecessary songs on that album. Definitely. But I want to go back to Birthday, because Birthday is one of my favorite songs on the record. I gotta go back. You can't deny this record, dog.
That shit is it.
Come on, bro. Hey. Is she bad enough? Yes.
That shit finna ring in the club.
I'm telling you, bro.
And I can't wait to be in the club and all these bitches be like with their tongue out and doing all that shit. I'm gonna be like, yeah. I'm like, hey, bitch.
Hey, where the hook at? I'ma give a good dick set back. Cash kicked in on the worst day. Oh, quit capping, girl, you know it ain't your birthday. Hey, who birthday? Put your... That shit hard.
That shit hard.
Shout out to the Migos on that record. That shit go crazy. Nah, definitely. The Migos were also on LA Leakers. I almost said LA Reekers. My apologies to y'all niggas. Just Incredible, Sour Milk, all the shit. But they killed this shit too. So I'm going to throw to this real quick. Why don't we?
Yeah, go ahead.
Don't get it, just send me the ad and my niggas will ship it. A million 20s and 50s and 100s sitting on the floor, look how I swim in it. Don't wanna get popped, don't open your top, you better move militant. They talking about COVID when I heard the news, I started sipping the remedy. If I got a op and you say you my brother, then it better be your enemy. I'm taking them back to the band on way back when the nigga was breaking the interim. Stay with the tree like a Timberland. Lady got guy in that Kimberly. Cap of the Japanese snitching, these niggas be snitching, they acting real.
Yeah,
and I will say I'm glad I seen it was trending. Takeoff was trending for a while after this album was released.
Yes,
and everybody was trending. Everybody was finally understanding that Takeoff has been gassing this whole fucking time. Every time, like Takeoff be floating on shit, and like he was floating all through this album, just like he's done on his previous albums. But like he's now getting
his flowers now. He getting his flowers now.
His respect, and it's, which well is deserved. Dope. Yeah, which it's is well dope deserved. Because
hey, third time's a charm, though, right? Mm-hmm. That's what they say. But yeah, shout out to Takeoff. Shout out to Quavo. Shout out to Offset. This was a good album. Of course, redeeming themselves from
Where's Bobby?
Culture 2. Where is Bobby?
I was expecting a Bobby verse somewhere.
Bobby, I thought Bobby might have been on the album too, but god damn it.
They gave this nigga a whole chain and like $50,000 and hella shit. Like, my nigga, I couldn't get a verse.
Nope. Not for the album, man. You get the Pop Smoke joint that you already had. You get the Juice WRLD joint that you already had. Damn, they got Pop and Juice on that motherfucker.
Yeah.
That's crazy. They got Polo G on the album as well. You feel me? And that was just, we got a lot of great music, not only from Migos, but from Polo, but from Kodak. And yes, Justin Bieber is also on the album. You know what? I will say that What You See record was okay. But I liked the Time For Me record a little bit more than that.
I think I like that song.
The Time For Me joint?
Mahomes was all right.
Mahomes was mid.
Yeah, Mahomes was
mid. I'm not mad at Mahomes like making the album, but Mahomes could have not made the album.
Yeah. I wasn't mad at the placement of it and how it flowed. It didn't stand out.
If I'm gonna be honest, like the Juice WRLD record was mid. Rest in peace to Juice WRLD, but I mean,
yeah, it was cool.
I didn't really need that record. It was okay, but it wasn't nothing that like. Really
I know why it's there though.
Well, of course,
it's there. Same reason why Drake is there. The Drake song's there. Yes.
There, yeah. I mean that and the Pop. Those are all beneficial for streaming.
Yeah.
But there you go.
The Pop song could have stayed on the album. The other two I could have been without.
Other two, maybe, yeah, I feel you. I understand.
Yeah,
I
but out of five, I give it a 4. A solid 4.
Good job. I'm gonna give it a 3.5. Good job, Migos. Migos. I'm gonna give y'all a 3.5.
This is going to last throughout the summer, throughout the end of the year.
Mm-hmm.
I tell you that. Shit's open back again. Some of these songs are going to be. Is it better than Baby and Dirk?
Yep.
Oh. All right, so look.
Maybe we should come back next week.
We can come back next week.
No, it is different.
But I will say this. I'll say this. The albums are a little bit different, but this has a lot more outside appeal than Baby and Dirk. Like, I feel like this has some songs that are going to last because they're going to be able to be played in the clubs. Brand new in the club songs, which we ain't had in a while. You know, DJs be stagnant, been playing like the last couple of like real club hits we didn't had from two years ago and shit. But like Birthday is finna be in rotation somewhere.
Yeah.
The
Picasso
Straightening. Yeah, Picasso.
With the flow like a mob spinning inside the vans, I buy shoes so dirty from running from cops. Boom.
Yeah, definitely.
But you know, Dirk and Baby finna be in the whip. Niggas is finna be riding around slapping that. That's so. The Migos might have a little bit more lifespan with the being in the clubs and shit.
We'll see. Very interesting.
Yeah, we'll see.
Very interesting. In addition to the Migos, you feel me? Like we said, they got a lot of dope features on there. And why don't we throw to Polo G? Because Polo G in this Hall of Fame album, dog, this is what, his third album. And this is one of those situations where it is, it kind of feels like this is a coming out party or a coming of age situation for Polo G.
Yeah, this album is definitely his like break into mainstream.
Yeah, like his breakthrough, know? His breakthrough, yeah, because project or something.
He's
yeah.
been putting in the work and he's been making noise, but now he's starting to get some mainstream success. Yes. As you can see with his track listing, he got a mainstream bag
mm-hmm.
to where he can got features like Lil Wayne, Nicki Minaj, Kid LaRue, DaBaby, Roddy Ricch, Young Thug, Rod Wave. Like,
it's going up.
None of those names are cheap.
No.
None of those names are cheap. But,
I mean, the Kid definitely deserves probably it. The cheapest feature that he has on here.
Yeah, that and that's still a bag.
I have no idea who Scory is.
And I guarantee you it was Scory because Kid LaRae is
that's a Lil Bibby, right? That's Lil Bibby's artist? The Kid LaRae?
I'm not sure.
LaRae? I'm not sure. Or whatever. I feel like he's somebody's, like, because Bibby did the Juice WRLD deal, and then I think he has this other dude too, but. I'll look into that.
Definitely. That's where Bibby's been.
That's where Bibby's
been collecting. Yes. He just been collecting. Oh,
Bibby shout been out cool. Bibby. He been chilling. Sitting yeah, back.
You feel me? I ain't gonna checks. Lie. I follow him on Instagram, but I did yeah. not know what the fuck he was doing.
Chilling.
Yeah, but this Polo G album though. Oh yep, man, so.
Hall let of me Fame. Tell you. This let is a better Hall you. Of Fame album than Big Sean. I'll say that.
Abso-fucking-lutely. I will say this. I know of Polo G. I listened to a few of his songs, his singles and everything. And I like Polo G. I never really deep dove and like sat down with his projects and really digested them. So, mm-hmm. you know, I was a little wet behind the ears jumping into this. But boy, oh boy. I have listened to this album probably like 6 times.
Have you listened to it more than any other album that you've listened to this week?
Yes.
Mm, okay.
I've listened to this album more than any other album probably that's dropped this year already. Like in wow. a short amount of span, in a short amount of time.
Okay.
Like just
As far as like from release date to the time that we recorded.
Yeah, album. Yeah, absolutely. Okay, absolutely.
Understand.
And this album has what, 17 tracks on it? 18 tracks on it? Oh, 20. Excuse me.
20.
20 tracks. Yeah.
I think it's like an hour, minutes. Right? It's just under an yep. hour or about an 54 hour?
54 minutes.
Eagles gave us like an hour and 15 minutes. And like, I appreciated that. But this is, yeah, just yeah. about an hour long. Good record, man. What's your favorite record on this song? On this album, excuse me. And I know that's probably like a loaded question at this point.
Oh, no. I can tell you my favorite. I've been going back to it over and over again. Epidemic.
Mm. I think that came out before the album came out too.
Yeah, but that
that's only cool. been out for a second. But yeah, Epidemic
that,
is
that, a good that, one. Painting Pictures. He started off and oh my god, oh look, my god, yeah.
I'm gonna tell you
his
like
storytelling
this.
Is nice.
Yeah, painting.
You know
pictures?
these Chicago niggas, they storytelling yeah. is top.
They can do it. They can definitely do it. So from painting pictures to Blackhearted.
Blackheart's hard.
Broken guitars.
Bloody canvases.
Bro, the melody on this broken guitars.
Yes, so hard.
I was like, yes. But yeah,
I was like,
even
like,
so, and I accidentally went to that one. But yeah, like you were saying, Bloody Canvas, That might be, as far as storytelling, my favorite record.
Yeah. Yeah. Duh. I was like, oh my God. This is deep.
I gotta stop it.
Yeah. Whew. Yeah. Nah. Heart of a Giant with Red Rod Wave.
Yeah, definitely.
Man.
What'd you think of the Nicki record, the For the Love of New York?
I like it. I liked it.
Do you like it because you like it as it's like a good song and a song that you can see yourself playing, or do you like it because these are like the types of songs necessary to get to where you want to go?
Yeah, I like it for Polo. I like it for him.
That's what I feel like. I like it for Polo
because, but like, yeah, it didn't fit. He had a couple of songs that didn't necessarily. It didn't like fit the flow of the album.
Mm-hmm.
But I see why they were on the album. Like, one of my favorite songs that he released like a year and a half ago, that GNF, Give No Fucks, Okay.
Yeah, and that just happened to be on the album. And it's That's in the middle.
Yeah, and it's, I was going to say, and it's right in the middle. And like, it don't necessarily need to be there, but I love that fucking song. I have it on my playlist, and like, I be playing that shit in the car all the time and just be slapping it when I feel like being on my turf shit. But
you know what? The Migos Pop Smoke record, that record sounds like Dior. But Clueless.
I like Clueless with Fabio.
I like Clueless with Fabio and Pop. Yes.
And they did this together, you could tell, because Pop was saying his name in the hook.
Yes, exactly. Right. And that's dope. I also fuck with that Losses record with Young Thug.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was a really good song. I think that should be a single.
Doug.
And I hope that it is.
This whole album, Toxic is hard.
Yeah, Toxic is hard.
Like, Toxic this whole is definitely album, hard. This whole album is dope. I can't front. This whole project is dope. Like, I listened to it before I listened to Migos, and I feel like the very first thing I did, I think I text you or I hit you, and I was like, bro, have you listened to this? Yeah.
And I hadn't listened to it yet. I want to make that clear. I had not listened to it yet until you said that, and you were like, dog, listen to this because we need to talk this out.
I called like three people with that same sentiment. Was like, bro, have you listened to this Polo G album? And like, I'm not the type of person, like, well, I'm not gonna just reach out and just push somebody else's shit just on the strength. But like, nah, it caught me off guard, and it was that damn good. So I'll speak high praises on this Hall of Fame album.
Nah, you said it right. Just some Hall of Flame shit.
Yeah, he did Hall of Flame. Shout out to Tycoon, man.
Right. Hey, definitely shout out to Kuhn, man. Hey,
shout out to Kuhn, man. Shout out to the homie Tycoon. Yes, Hall of Flame.
Kuhn on the track, finna rip like a runner.
Yeah. You know. But out of five, I get it. I'm saying
that I don't even think that was Kuhn's line, but regardless, I think
something on the track got to rip like a runner. I don't know what that was. Rip like a runner.
Is it Taji on? I don't know if that was it. I don't know if that was it. I don't think that was it. But okay. Got you. Okay, cool. But since we're on Polo, we gotta talk about this. Out of five? Before we do that, yes indeed. Let's get as many as flowers before we do that. Four. I'm gonna give this a four.
Okay.
Migos get the 3.5 for me. I give Polo a four. For sure.
I gave him two.
I'll probably play this more than Amigos record just because this is more of the shit that, like, for me personally. But like, if I'm like chilling with like if I'm with a little billionaire or something like that, yeah. Sure. We throwing on that when that drink kicking, she feels sexy.
I'll tell you this.
Sure. All day.
I'll tell you this.
Yeah.
I might play this. I might be playing this album more than Lil Baby and Durk, and I really like Lil Baby and Durk's album. I compare those two albums, Polo's and Lil Baby and Durk, way more than I would put Migos. Migos is, like you said, the more party type shit. Like, if you got a little Ben in around, you could throw on the Migos tape and parlay too and chop it up too. But like,
right.
if you just by yourself smoking, drinking, or driving, doing whatever, you know, and you got to pick between, damn, should I throw on the Polo album or should I throw on the Lil Baby and Durk album? Oh, that's a tough one, but I might throw on Polo just because I got a little bit more story, you know, I got a little bit more meat in there. Mm.
I feel you. Okay,
but I do like that Durk and Lil Baby. I'm gonna make a playlist of both of them. It's gonna be a good summer, nonetheless. But I think you were talking about you want to go into the Polo G incident.
Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, this unfortunate incident surrounding Polo G's album release. He was arrested and then since released, so no worries there. Bonded out. However, the situation is just quite interesting and a little bit disturbing to me because this is not the first nor second nor third time that a rapper or entertainer has been arrested in the Miami area this year, 2021. So I don't know what's going on, but it does seem as if it's hot out there.
Yeah, aka Rolling Loud's about to happen in Miami, y'all niggas.
Yeah. Be cool. Hey, and by the way, last time Rolling Loud was in Miami, I think, or was it Rolling Loud Orlando? They did that sweep, and they pulled up on Kodak, and that's when they got Kodak, and that's why Kodak was gone for about 2 years. So,
yeah.
Hey, niggas finna, please.
Niggas finna be out there, be on your P's and Q's.
Be smooth.
Have your T's crossed and your I's dotted.
Yeah. So, I mean, I hate to bring this back up and pull this, but Polo G arrested for alleged battery on a police officer, resisting arrest and other charges. I thought that this was a very unfortunate situation. I'm not exactly sure how this got to the level in which it got at, as far as what the reports were saying. But I do think that he was targeted. And as he says here on his Twitter page after he bailed out, one of the officers told us they was on us since we got out, since we got off of our jet, excuse me. And they playing foul in Miami and that shit been like that for a minute. And these are, you know, words straight from Polo G's mouth, who I believe will probably have a number one album this week, if not for the great music that he put out, but for the controversy that will lead people to listen to the good music that he put out.
Okay, yeah. Prayers up for Polo. Hopefully that case gets resolved quickly and without any time being served or have to be served. But like you said, it is unfortunate. Who else just was in Miami that just got arrested or just had to turn themselves in?
I believe it was DaBaby and his crew. Not two weeks or so ago.
Somebody just
Bandman Kevo
just turned themselves in. They're in jail right now. What artist is it? God damn it! It's on the tip of my tongue.
Somebody just turned themselves in. Pusheisty.
Yeah. Pusheisty, there we are. Bam.
Pusheisty. Yes.
Pusheisty's in Miami.
Mm-hmm. And that was because of the KOD incident about a week or so ago.
Yep.
Where he proved, yes indeed, I don't need no security. I got my own fire. And that's not me saying allegedly. Security. That's because there was a video where he was brandishing a firearm walking out of the establishment. So... but I mean, hey, bro, whatever it is, like, regardless, it does seem as if there's a microscope on this city right now.
Yeah, let me tell y'all, Miami is the new, is the 2021 version of New York back in the mid 2000s. And late 2000s. Remember when they had all the hip hop police out there?
Yep.
And every time niggas used to go to New York, niggas would get arrested, catch cases in New York, and they'd be targeting all rappers and everything when they slid out there. It's the same shit that's happening in Florida. Same exact shit that's happening out there. So niggas just gotta be careful, be on their shit, man.
Niggas definitely got to be careful.
But that just sucks. It happened on his album release date.
On his album release party. And you know what?
Do you have any numbers?
Do I have any numbers? Yes, I do have numbers, and we'll get back to this because I do have something else that I would like to say. But in regards to the numbers, Polo G's Hall of Fame album does look like it is headed for a number one debut on Billboard. He's looking at about 165 to 175,000 as far as sales. So it is projected right now currently as the number one album in the country. You know what? I had a record for the Migos, but I'm not particularly sure where that one is, but the Migos are looking like they're doing about 135 or something to that effect. Yeah. If I'm not mistaken, so the Migos Culture 3 is looking like it's doing about 125, 135. So actually, right here, I found it. Migos aiming for a top three debut of the U.S. albums chart with 125 to 135,000 units sold. So shout out to them. I believe Olivia Rodrigo was somewhere within that top three. Yes, indeed. So probably Polo G. Olivia Rodrigo and Migos. Also, in regards, is this what?
Does this hurt Migos?
Does this hurt Migos? What? The fact that they don't have a number one album on this week? No. Third Time's a Charm is their third official album. Culture 3, them landing at the three spot is just fate.
Okay. You know, I would just think, I don't know, maybe I'm just putting added pressure.
I think they're perfectly fine.
You got the new artist, little baby that came in and just like,
mm-hmm. Oh, he crushed the bill.
LeBron James the shit and gets number ones, and then he just dropped a number one with Dirk like a week ago.
And speaking of which, that's Dirk's first number one album. So shout out to Dirk on that. Yeah. Yes, indeed. And if we want to talk about numbers, but definitely. I think all of these spots are exactly where they should be, if I'm being completely honest with you. I think they're exactly.
I don't know about Olivia. I haven't listened to her album.
I've seen her trending for the last 2 weeks or so, and
she probably deserves even it.
Parks was talking about he listened to it and it was a great album. And if Parks, the backpack rap engineer connoisseur, you feel me, is like, yo, that's a great album. You feel me? I believe it, and I understand the hype around it. If that's the case, going back to Polo G, because I do want to finish this out and close this out. Unfortunately, it is in an man, I'll just play the video, man. Shout out to Polo G's mom. Fuck all you niggas that's doing some fuck shit, but I gotta call bullshit on this case. I just feel like it's complete bullshit, but I'll play the video.
And then when I go and approach them to ask them about my children, and namely my minor son who's 16, they tell us if we don't leave that they're gonna lock us the fuck up. I need y'all to spam.
They marched. They march. Okay, I must have fought the police that march down the street.
I do not know if my children are safe. What's going on? I do not know if my children are safe, and I need you mother to flood Miami fucking police department and tell them to let my sons go.
She said, they marching the police car. They in the police car. I said, yo. I got to call bullshit on this because looking at the articles that were released in regards to like the reports of this actual situation, like he wasn't driving. They were in a licensed vehicle, of course, being driven by security detail and shit like that. The report and the documents that were submitted in regards to what was happening here, it says that, where do I start? The Miami Herald reported that Officer Brandon Carrero allegedly got into a struggle with the rapper Polo G. According to the officer, Joseph Acuna, who was in the crime scene, and the report described Polo G striking Officer Carrero multiple times in the head, forehead, and cheek while, where does it say? While Carrero was trying to handcuff him and shouting these words, and I quote, "I will kill you. I swear I will use these fists to beat the shit out of you and knock your ass out while in custody." If you're telling me that someone that was irritated, pissed off, and aggravation, anger boiling to that level was able to articulate themselves in this manner saying, and I quote once again, "I will kill you. I swear I will use these fists to beat the shit out of you and knock your ass out." I'm calling bullshit on Mr. Officer Acuna, whatever the fuck your name is. This is bullshit. This is cap. Sorry. Gotta say it. And oh, this is definitely capitalized. And I like that you said that. I love that you said that. Because yeah, I gotta call a spade a spade. I gotta call a buck. This is cap.
Yeah.
You recorded.
You cap.
Shout out to Soulja Boy.
You cap.
Always shout out to Soulja Boy. Big Soulja, big Draco. But yeah.
Soulja Boy was probably the first nigga arrested to tell the cops, with these fists, I beat the shit out of you.
Guaranteed, there's probably video footage of it too. Hey, you know what? Hey, not to jump off the subject real fast, but thing I do like about Soulja Boy, Soulja Boy be pulling up receipts on you bitch ass niggas. He got videos and he got pictures and he got motherfucking timestamps on you bitch ass niggas. He be like, I was the first. Look, boom.
Tell me I wasn't.
And tell me I like, wasn't. Damn.
Lie and tell me I wasn't.
I thought this nigga be on some shit. He be pulling up receipts. I hope that bitch ass cop get whatever he deserve, because y'all need to be lying on niggas. Like, ain't no nigga from the hood gonna say, I'm gonna use these fists right here to beat your ass. Hey, like, come on now.
We'll keep it those are not the words I'm using.
Not the words I'm using. I can see if I say I'm gonna kill y'all, I might say that, but everything else considered with it, yeah. I'm going to say I'm going to beat your ass, you bitch ass motherfucker. Like, it's going to be hella cuss words. It's going to be hella shit. And I'll never say I'm going to use this fist. Yeah,
it's going to be hella disjointed speech.
You're going to catch these hands. But, like, me referring to, like, using my hands in some type of way and say, I'm going to use these fists to knock you. Nah, nigga. Throw the whole case out. That ain't even in my vocabulary. That's fist ain't even bullshit. In my vocabulary.
I ain't never said the word fist.
Right.
That's so funny. Definitely. Shout out to Polo G. Number one album, it looks like, and much deserved. Yes, indeed. So, yeah, fuck that cop. Go ahead, please.
Speaking of number ones, we might have a number one single I'm hearing about, which is coming with a lot of controversy. From your girl, who was recently on a hiatus, and she is in our go or no spot. Miss Thot Shit herself.
Okay, Miss Tina Snow.
Miss Tina Snow. Miss Meg the Stallion. Oh, that's the typo. I should be the THEE.
Don't worry about it. I'll figure it out.
Yeah. But yeah. Miss Meg, she back from her hiatus, you know what I'm saying? Her hiatus, you know what I mean? She went on a little,
About two months, six weeks.
And she came back as Tina Snow, and, you know, she's on some more hot girl shit with her thought shit, you know what I mean?
Some more hot girl shit with her thought shit. Okay, so is this record a go or a no?
I'm going to have to wait on it. I'm not going to necessarily say, yeah, I'm not going to say no. I'm not going to say no. It's not a go to me off rip. I like it. It's high energy and everything. I've heard a little better from Meg. Like, she's getting a lot of controversy right now because a lot of people are saying basically she's giving us reheated soup, which is basically the same thing over and over. But I'm not mad at that, because if you're going to be mad at that, then you got to get mad at the baby and all his efforts, because he's giving you the same thing over and over again and you keep eating it up like cake. So I can't get mad at that on Meg, but I could get mad at the effort. And I feel like it could have been just a little better on the effort side. But if this is going to have all the hoes out there grabbing their ankles and shaking their ass like the twerkulator shit, you know what I mean? I'm all for it. So I'm going to have to wait on it to see if the hoes is going to do a challenge, because usually her shit comes with a challenge. And if her shit come with a challenge, then I'm finna be with it. But if not, then it's just gonna be waiting till the next shit. You know what I mean? This ain't Big Ol' Freak.
Her shit usually comes with a challenge. No, it's not Big Ol' Freak. It is not. I do have a clip from the behind the scenes footage of the video. The nigga had the camera attached to her ass or her hips and shit. Anyways, y'all will see it if you're... Here it is.
Let's see that. That's a hell of a porno angle.
It is. It definitely is. And I'm not mad at it.
I love that point of view.
I'm actually happy.
I wonder how many shots he said he needed of that. Because I for sure would have had like nine different shots. Like,
what?
Damn, I messed up. One more, mate.
One more.
Run that back one more time.
Maybe two more.
Yeah.
I ain't going to hold you. I'm going to need one of these shots for my personal collection.
Yeah, that's why you think I got so many. I would have been like, the one that I deleted? Oh, yeah.
Bluetooth. Oh, yeah, for sure.
I airdropped that bitch to my
right to...
You know, these cameras is high tech now. You can Bluetooth this shit right away, nigga.
Real quick. That motherfucker is mine.
That motherfucker is mine.
You feel me?
Yeah, but I'm going to have to wait on this because I'm going to need to see if all the hoes are finna be out there, like, on that.
I'm going to need to see what the hoes do to this. She had the thought bus in L.A. going Yankee. You feel me? I saw that. I wasn't mad at that. However, what I am mad about is all of these niggas that are trying to criticize her for this record. I don't give a fuck if this is the same thing that she raps about all the time or if she raps about this the majority of the time. Pusha T raps about dope every fucking album. You feel me? Like, D'Amigo rap about drip and swag and all of that shit. You feel me? Exactly. You feel me? Like, dog, it doesn't fucking matter. If this is their bag for their content, let this be the bag for their content. All you niggas that's out here talking about, you feel me, or insinuating that you want Meg to do some old, like, conscious rap shit or, like, refer to, like she needs to go down to the lane of like Rhapsody or like Jean Grey or some shit like that and get on some backpack rap. Shut the fuck up. Cause you niggas ain't buying no Jean Grey. You niggas ain't buying no Rhapsody fucking records. You feel me? Rhapsody, if that's the case, should be platinum every fucking time out because Meg is.
Facts.
You feel me? So what the fuck are we really talking about and what are you niggas complaining about? That's what I want to
complain.
They complaining about bullshit. You niggas need to go out and get you some hoes, get you some bitches. You feel me? Because, dog, clearly, you have none. Zero hoes. Yeah. Goose egg. Get your shit together.
You know what it is? When people can't relate to a song or when people feel like a song isn't for them, they automatically go to, like, it's trash. Trying to
shit on it, or
it's trash. This is whoop. You should do this to please my personal listening palette, and it's like, nah.
And you know what? To that, I have one question.
Why?
Why? Yeah, for real. I don't know, but that's just some people, you know, people have an ownership problem. People think that like, I'm a fan of this artist. So since I'm a fan of this artist, I'm your fan. You owe me to do whatever I feel you should do.
Mm-hmm. You need to fulfill my needs and my wants and what I'm looking for from you that I'll never be able to really tell you. What the fuck? I don't fucking know you. You don't know me. Like, they don't owe you shit.
Nope. But the internet gives everybody a voice and, you know, get enough people together with a similar idea, then they're gonna make some noise and you become trending. So that's all that shit is. It's just a couple haters got together and just was on some bullshit. But I'm excited to hear more Meg. I do have a question. Can the city did the city girls or what are those girls called? The city girls?
Which girls?
City girls? Yeah, city girls.
The City Girls.
Yeah, because the City Boys. So the City Girls and like Hotties get along.
Or the Hot Girls or whatever. I don't
yeah,
know.
Yeah, do they funk or like are they like on separate sides of the spectrum? Like do
yes, they up? Clearly. Yeah, we've been funking for like, remember last year, the City Girls and the Hot Boys or the City Boys? No. You feel me?
I know the girls and the boys been funking. I said do the City Girls and the Hotties.
Oh, do the City Girls and the Hotties be funking? That is a good question.
Are they,
I don't think so.
Like, are they on the same, like, can the twerkulators
so. And can honestly, the thot shits if I'm gonna be honest like, with you,
incorporated together?
I think what's happening lately is,
how do I
think
I
what's happening? I think what's happening lately is the City Girls, the Barty Gang, and the Hotties have all been a little bit on defense when it comes to the Barbs.
And the Barbs is back.
Nikki does seem to be sending some shots, and it's in my opinion, I think the Hotties, the City Girls, and what was the other group that I said? I think they're all wondering.
The Barbs.
The Barty Gang.
Yeah.
So the City Girls, the Hotties, and the Barty Gang are all wondering who are these shots at? Who is Nikki talking about? Mm. That's what's happening right now. That's what I see. That's what I'm seeing.
You know, it's a lot of cattiness going on. It's a lot of women business that I need to stay out of.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's a whole bunch of women business I need to stay out of.
I agree with
but
you.
But I'm just happy that we're getting more music for these women because it's mm-hmm. going to be outside and ladies, I'm single, and I'm trying to see y'all singling out there. So, like, if y'all want to be singling to these, yeah, damn, y'all want to be singling to these taken women. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, I'll enjoy.
Enjoy.
I'll enjoy. Enjoy. Let's see, but that's all I got for music.
Oh, is that all you have for music? Because I mean, there's a freestyle.
Oh, you want to go on December right now?
Nah. Let's not. Because more importantly, because if I'm going to be honest with you, in my opinion, Simba dropped a classic freestyle. But if we're going to take the conversation the other way and we're going to talk about some bullshit, let's talk about some shit. All right? Because from what I've seen and from what I've read, it seems as if Kanye is tired of keeping up with the motherfucking Kardashians, okay?
Yeah, buddy.
From what I've seen and what I've read, it looks like Kanye allegedly unfollowed Kim and the entire fucking Kardashian fucking clan.
Yeah, buddy.
And Kanye may be dating motherfucking superstar model. I forget what her name is. Ariana or whatever. You feel me? That's not her name. It's not Ariana. But do we have classic Ye on the way? I feel like if Ye's dating supermodels, if Ye's back on the scene, if Ye is, you feel me, sliding around, fucking with it, you feel me, just, if I fuck this model, and she just bleached her asshole. If Ye is walking around with bleach on his t-shirt, nigga, we got a classic Ye,
you know, we got a classic
on the
coming.
Way.
Yeah.
We got a classic on the way, man.
Nah, I'm happy for Ye, man. He finally got somebody, finally hit him with the flash in his face a couple of times. Yeah, you know what I mean, woke his game up. He got out the little get out Twilight Zone and shit, and realized
my nigga
that
got
you
out
know,
the he got out the what's this shit called, the sunken place.
The go. Sunken place, there it is. Yeah, he got off the sunken place and everything, and you know he gets back to him. And he seems
place.
To be. Nah, for real. He seems to be a little bit more, I'm not going to say he seems to be more happy since the whole Kim thing, but he was
going through a
lot.
Honestly, I have no idea if he's more happy. I'm not seeing him in the public eye anymore at this point. Well, you feel me? And when I do see him, it seems as if he's got like a mask on or something like that. So I don't really know.
Well, that last picture, he just had a mask on. But he.
I mean, even at the DMX funeral, he had a mask on.
He did, I guess, on the DMX being on too. But no, I mean, like, since the past, over the past, like, 3-4 years, he's been, like, having turmoil with his relationship with Kim. back and forth. There's been divorce rumors over and over. So seems like he's finally like moving onwards, which is, I feel like that's always a good sign when you see somebody like moving on or, you know, pushing forward. So I just hope everything's good with Ye. He just dropped his Gap jacket. That shit sold out in like minutes.
What do you think about $200?
The jacket was all right.
It was all right.
It wasn't bad. I feel like the photo of it and how
I don't think the photo
the picture of it was unflattering. Yeah.
I don't think the photo does it justice.
He had a picture of him wearing the jacket with the mask on. That picture with him in the mask on when he's walking around. That blue jacket he's wearing is that Gap jacket. And it looks all right on him. That's what I'm saying.
The paparazzi picture version of it, and I think the paparazzi version picture of the jacket is unflattering. So I don't know I haven't seen any additional photos, me personally. But I mean, hey.
I say this, I never doubt. I can't count out Kanye or doubt Kanye because he seems to thrive off of any time somebody doubts him or any time somebody says,
"Isn't that so funny?" Something.
No. That's Kanye's MO. If we're looking at it and we're talking like, dog, if I'm speaking frank and we just like, you feel me, nigga, like, you know how we get down. Check this out, bro.
Yeah.
Kanye might be the most successful artist ever.
Ever.
And I mean that, mean that from a standpoint of every fucking
everything he does.
Every turn that he's made and every interest that he's had the door closed on him and motherfuckers have told him, you're not good enough. You can't sit at this table. We don't think that you can do it. You feel me? Like, and he's literally proved every single person wrong along the way.
What makes him great is the fact that not only he proves them wrong and completes that task, he brings along people and puts them in positions or gets positions for people after him that would have never got. Like, there are so many people in the fashion world that are running fashion right now that come directly from Kanye's camp.
Yep.
Directly from Kanye's camp.
Picasso is dead.
And so it's like, yeah, you might hate him. He might have to bite the bullet or take a few shots on the way through the door, but what's once you get in that motherfucker,
Don C, Nike,
Don C, yeah,
Virgil, Louis, yeah, that,
or whatever, just Don, you feel me? That's him,
yeah, that's Don C, like,
yeah,
you feel me? Like, come on,
you got Virgil, the cactus, the cactus plant, the cactus flea market, chick. She came from Kanye. Like, it's a lot of people that's been branched off of the Kanye.
Yeah, like, the Kanye Rihanna tree is fruitful.
Rihanna wouldn't be in her position if Kanye didn't break down.
I 100% agree with that. And that's a fact. That's a fact, because Ye had to go through that shit. So, nigga, Ye did that, so hopefully you wouldn't have to go through that. You feel me? The whole line. You know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah, because that's, to be honest,
that's what that is.
Yeah, because to be honest, Jay-Z and Diddy previously tried to break into that world and were denied and shunned. They had the door closed. Yeah. And guess what? They just turned around and folded and kept going with something else. Kanye didn't.
Rockaware, Sean John, those were successful brands. They were successful brands, but they weren't successful to the level of, you know what I'm saying, being able to.
They were urban brands. They were considered urban brands.
Exactly. They weren't looked at as high-end fashion brands such as the LVMH house, such as Balenciaga, such as Gucci, such as Moncler or whatever. You feel me? A number of things. They weren't looked at as that. But Fenty is. But Yeezy is. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, yeah, shout out to that. That's Ye. That's Ye. Definitely. Big facts.
Steve Jobs is dead.
You know what I'm saying? So, I expect more great shit coming with the fact that he kicked the rest of the clan to the curb. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, man. 100K, yay.
100K, yay. 100K, yay. Nah. Speaking of 100K, man.
Not 100K,
nah. 100K Harden, dog.
100K Harden. 100K okay.
Harden. Honey Bun Harden.
Hey, ballin'.
Honey Bun Harden.
Honey Bun Harden.
Yeah.
Big facts, man. Big
facts. I heard Honey Bun Harden got a sweet tooth or a sweetie tooth.
Big Birkin, man.
Big Birkin, man.
You know how Saweetie's Birkin's been talking on IG? He said, hey, let me talk to you. Talk to me. I talk back.
Yeah. 100K Harden, man. Nice.
What is we talking about here, man? James Harden. Cash App Saweetie, $100,000 just for a date. This is alleged. This is definitely alleged. However, if you've been paying attention to the Sheep Show within recent weeks, you would know that we've been covering this for quite some time. And it does seem as if James Harden has some groupie tendencies.
Hey, I'll say this. You know, Joe Budden said his price is
the $2,500, right?
$2,500. That's justifiable. Mm-hmm. James Harden up that.
Nigga, for 40 days and 40 nights.
James Harden said, my price is 100K.
For 40 days and 40 nights, my nigga James Harden said, what's your Cash App code? Exactly. You feel me? And you know what's funny about that was, you know, because, you know, every one of these apps has their own limits, has their own, you feel me, like, they have some structure to it to where, like, okay, yeah, you can spend this much money, but only this much money per day. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Niggas had me on my neck talking about, wait, $100,000 for one date? That means for the last 40 days, he's been sending her $2,500 a day. You know, like, I mean, I doubt that would be the case, you feel me? And then I seen another nigga say, I mean, I thought the Cash App, you could only send $2,500 a day. So unless James Harden has some special NBA deal Cash App, I don't know how this is possible. And I'm here to tell you, it's not possible. You can't send $100,000 in one day. I don't care if you're an NBA player or what have you, but
yes,
you can. I am here for the jokes.
Yes, you can. I am here for
every single one of the jokes.
You can definitely send 100K.
Not through Cash App.
Nope, but you can wire it just like Cash App, so I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, you can do a wire transfer, yeah.
So maybe he didn't.
Cash App was just he wired it,
and they said, oh, it was a Cash App because it was money sent.
That's what I'm saying. Cash App
is like Kleenex or Google.
Cash App was the thing that went ahead and made it go viral, that piqued everybody's interest, that gave it that doubt, but also gave it that... I mean, well, who's to say that he didn't send her $100,000? Maybe he didn't send it through Cash App.
That's where James Harden can come out and say, "What are you talking about?
I didn't cash app her anything.
Yeah, I didn't Cash App her anything. I Zelled it. Duh.
I Zelled it. You feel me?
I Zelled it. It was a big amount. I can't cash
that. That's crazy, man.
Come on, man.
Crazy, man.
We can't have that. I can't have that ledger in my friends list. They're looking at James Harden transaction and say 100K to Saweetie.
Hey. Does it show that on Cash App too? Like, if you look at, like, you can see other people.
It shows on like Venmo.
I know on Venmo, you could be like, oh shit, Goldmine just sent $50 to the bin in there for busting it wide open. Okay, that's cool. That's
chill.
Crazy.
Get
that's
out my transactions, nigga.
My bad, you can see them? But what I'm saying is.
Look, I told her to stop putting a description.
Right. That's a big fact. Hey, as much as like the jokes on this was funny, I feel like when 50 Cent steps into the chat, he steps a little bit.
Yeah, he a step.
he's definitely a line stepper, an habitual line stepper, if I will say. Yeah. 50 Cent went ahead and said, yo, at Quavo Huncho.
That nigga didn't go to neither of the niggas talking in the post. He said, let me go to the X real fast.
He didn't at James Harden. Mm-mm. He didn't at Saweetie. Nuh-uh. He said, yo, at Quavo Huncho.
Yo, you know, man, my mans.
He said, you know that song that y'all just put out, right? Talk about when that drink kick in, she feel sexy. When that 100K kick in, she feel sexy.
For real.
100K Harden said, you let me drop some on you. He said, 100K Harden said, she need a Birkin. I told her work it. She need a Birkin. Yeah. I told her work it. She need a Birkin. Yeah. I told her work it.
Hey, nah, that shit slid through on the wire transfer, and Sweetie instantly threw that song on in the background and started slapping it like, eh.
Sensational.
She put it on her Snapchat too, so she know Quavo still be following her.
That nigga, hey, allegedly, hey, I guess, it wasn't alleged when he gave Lil Baby $100,000.
Nah, it wasn't.
It wasn't alleged when he just gave Travis Scott the Track Hawk.
A fucking Track Hawk, yeah, another $100,000 car.
Was it the Cybertruck?
I don't know, but it was a $100,000 car. So that's all I know. It's $100,000 is his tag. So
100K Harden, man.
100K Harden, dog. I do have a question. So with this last minute move, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? Did Sweetie kind of just like shit on Quavo and win? You know what I mean? Quavo took the truck back and she like,
get that that's Bentley cute. Bag, but- that's cute. He said,
that's cute.
But I just had a nigga wire me $100K on an off day.
On an off day. $100K Harden. And she like, guess what? Harden. He ain't give you $100K, but he gave Baby $100K. And I know y'all. Ooh. You know what Ooh. I mean? Ooh. Like, is there some Ooh. Tension there? Like, Ooh. You know what I mean? Like,
kid.
Bam. Bam.
Yeah, Harden fucking with the ops, then fuck with the ex girlfriend. Like, Harden got a thing for the Migos? Like, he got a thing going up against the Migos or something? That's a
good question.
Congratulations. You played yourself.
That's a good question, man. I would hope not. I would definitely hope not.
Yeah, but big shout out to James Harden, you know what I mean? Big tripper, big tricker, big stepper, mm-hmm. you know what I mean?
Big stepper, big tripper, you feel me?
Yeah, yes, big indeed, Birkin. Man.
Yeah, man. I told her work it.
Yeah, I told her work it. That's what he said.
That nigga said, I'm finna send her $100,000 to maybe, possibly, spend some time with me. I'm just sitting here reading all of this, looking at all of this shit, even looking at James Harden's response. Like,
you know why? Because James Harden's thought process is, look, I gotta take like what Future and Moneybagg say and make it hard on the next. You know what I mean? I'm gonna send her the 100K. I'm gonna wire her the 100K.
For the next nigga to love you.
Making it hard and for the next nigga to love you. You know what I mean? He said,
"What a beautiful love. Give your love. You're so lovely. Everyone's so lovely."
You know what, James Harden? And if you don't. And I don't need it. So, like, even if we don't have a date, I don't need it, bitch. You know what I'm saying? I'm balling like that.
This is James Harden's mind state.
When we was younger, we would go smoke crack.
Nah, he tripping now.
For real, nigga. You talking about I'm going to send you $100K to maybe go on a date with me, bitch.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. Yeah, for real.
I don't know.
$100K Harden, I see you though. Honey Bun Harden.
Let's talk about some niggas really, 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 really out here. You know what? Interject. Fuck that. Because the Bay Area got the hottest LA Leakers freestyle this year, 2021. I'm talking about J. Cole was there. I'm talking about the Migos was just there. I'm talking about nigga, I don't give a fuck who else was there. I just seen Benny the Butcher on I-95 talking about first Rory and Maul, Joe break up, trying to get my cake. Fuck all that. Check this out, nigga. We coming live and direct. Shout out to Simba. You feel me? Going Yankee, nigga, in the motherfucking LA Leaguer studio. What is
getting pussy because his song got hot. I had a car before I had a daydream.
Okay. Right.
I had a crib before I knew how to cook when I was like 18. Most nights it was top ramen and baked beans, but I thug it out before asking moms for anything.
Yeah.
Now I'm in the hills with no service, trying to dodge bitches who fucking without a purpose. I will never let a woman make me feel less of a man because I don't want to buy a Birkin. Send me back to the streets and I send you back to your mama's house. Happy hour dining, free drinks, and back to your mama couch. You just want a nigga with status to feel established, but it ain't enough room in this foreign for all your baggage.
Bitch, what? And what is we talking about?
Your baggage. That's the bar of the night.
He was tripping.
Yeah. Ain't no bitch finna make me feel less of a man for not buying a Birkin.
I don't want to buy her a Birkin.
Straight up.
You feel me? Shout out to Simba, man. And I stand by it. That is the best LA Leakers freestyle this year, 2021. Yeah. I mean, until Reason come back, I don't know who's going to top that. Reason been taking over the LA Leaguers for the last 2 years. I don't know, man.
But those that don't know though, or that ain't up on Simba, need to go follow him. Follow his IG and everything because he drops freestyles a lot.
Oh yeah,
He be eating. Definitely.
In addition to that, make sure you go grab that album, Don't Run From Rap, nigga.
There's a certain addiction with niggas and tricking that make it hard for women to tell who isn't. So you sort of Jordan Pippen, you scoring the system. I'm like Stockton and Malone. Once I pick them, I'm on roll. I'm going to them and get gone. I know that's probably wrong, but I married this money and I can't break a happy home. We about to drop the tape, so it's time that I set the tone.
Let's get it.
Got me in my zone. But Harry, we on, look.
What the fuck is you talking about, nigga? You go on that side, nigga. That's your side, nigga. Actually, I keep a blue flag hanging out. I keep a red flag. My bad. No disrespect. My bad.
Yeah, man.
Nigga, you leave, nigga. This is my show now. Fuck all that, nigga. I'm just kidding.
Yeah, man. Simba is one of the hottest out right now, though. Y'all go check him out. Go check his album out. Tap in with him. Y'all won't be disappointed.
Yeah, not at all. Nigga, he took that beat. He took that beat and beat that beat the fuck up. He took that beat and boxed that shit the fuck in. You feel
Where's
me?
Simba from? Not from Oakland, right?
You said what?
He's not from Oakland.
Oh,
Simba?
Shit,
where's he from?
What just happened? What the fuck is going on?
You all right? But yeah, so Simba, y'all check him out. He hot, man. And let's see, anything else we got on the list for this week? I don't think so. So y'all already know what to do. Y'all know where to go. Go follow us on Twitter and Instagram. On Twitter is @2blacksheep_.
I didn't know what the fuck was happening there. My shit was tripping. Nah, fuck that. Before we do that.
All right.
Because they can follow us at 2blacksheep on Twitter and on Instagram. You feel me? All that shit. Right. But just like Simba boxed that motherfucking beat the fuck up, all these celebrity boxing events been going on. I can't end the show without going in on these niggas and these celebrity boxing events because DDG just punched a nigga the fuck up.
I can't ignore it.
An amazing performance. Did you think it was gonna go the full fight?
Honestly, I left the strip club last night. I wasn't even training for this fight. Hey man, Jay, where my blunt at? I've honestly felt like, not to be funny or nothing, but I felt like he wasn't gonna last that whole time. It's a lot of respect to Nate.
You looked amazing. Honestly, coming from a professional fighter, you looked like you have been in the gym, you've been training. Can we talk about your coaching staff? You have some amazing coaches in your corner. Did you have confidence with them being there with you?
Yeah, Joe Diaz, he helped me a lot, sharpen up my skills. I'm excited for the win.
What's next for you, all right? You looked like you had a lot of fun. Can we see you in another fight? Can we see you in an amateur boxing match, a bare-knuckle boxing match? What's next?
Honestly, this is like my finale on YouTube. I'm quitting YouTube for good. So this is my last little finale of this fight. One and done. Unless, the only way I'll step in the ring again.
DDG says the only way he's going to step in the ring again is if he step in the ring with a rapper. Now, is it a rapper who's willing to step up? Where's YK Osiris when you need him?
Him and Blueface probably going to fight.
Him and Blueface, maybe.
They friends.
Like, I wouldn't be mad at that.
They probably split friends, a you bag.
Exactly. You feel me? And there ain't nothing wrong with that at all. You feel me? And that wasn't the only celebrity boxing event that went down. Of course, last week we had the Floyd Mayweather and the Logan Paul joint. You feel me? That went crazy. Got a million buys and all of that shit. 8 rounds of bullshit. Them niggas. You feel me? It is what it is. I didn't pay for it, so I'm not tripping. Friends. Also, damn near, you feel me? I wouldn't be. I know a lot of niggas is mad, and a lot of niggas is like, yo, I want a refund. So, I mean, it is what it is. But I know a lot of niggas probably also want a refund, not only from that, but from that Social Gloves event where DDG boxed at, where DJ Khaled performed all of like 42 seconds of All I Do Is Win. Is that what happened?
Oh, no. Where he ad libbed his own song that he was supposed to be rapping on. Like, nigga, you're not the DJ. You're the artist right now. You're supposed to be performing and not doing the ad libs like you were.
Did DJ Khaled have a verse on any of these records, though?
No. He's on the hook.
Does he wait? He doesn't have a verse on
No, that was T-Pain. That was T-Pain on the hook.
I feel like he has a verse on one of those really big records, but regardless. No,
I think he just talks over shit. Like, there's one of them, I think it's one or two of them where he just like talks over the beat for like 8 bars and then it comes back. Maybe that's what you're thinking of, but.
Maybe, possibly. Well, regardless of that, DDG punched the nigga the fuck up in the long awaited, much anticipated battle, celebrity boxing event between Lamar Odom and Aaron Carter for some reason happened as well over the weekend. And check it out.
Inside, you know, but Aaron's got to try to stay inside. That's the thing. He started keeping himself on the outside.
Whoa. Aaron's in trouble. Aaron got a spin technique going. Watch out, Aaron. Run.
Aaron's got to get inside. Jump.
Dude, I'm so sorry. What does the spinning do? Is that him rolling off of punches?
That was him just trying to get the fuck out the way.
Why were they fighting in the first place? Who told Aaron Carter to fight Lamar Odom?
I don't know where that beef came from. Like I don't know how that one started or what. But dog, the fact that Aaron Carter decided that he wanted to get into the ring with a certified dude that, in the words of Fat Joe,
when we was younger, we would go smoke crack.
You want to fight that nigga?
Right? You want to fight that nigga? For real?
You are bugging. You want to fight that nigga? Nah.
That nigga
tripping.
Fighting demons.
That right? Nigga is fighting all... That nigga for sure fighting demon time. The fuck?
That nigga fighting demons. Wow. I'm not trying to fight him. Mm-mm. I'm all the way
I'm
good.
Yeah,
the celebrity boxing thing is kind of entertaining. It's entertaining when you get a good entertaining like matchup.
Yeah.
But like...
I think the Ocho Cinco...
That was a good one. Ocho
the fact Cinco, that because of the fact that Ocho Cinco is not a boxer and the nigga that he boxed is an actual boxer, well, however, but he's not on the level. He's a fighter, but he's not on the level of somebody that you would look at and be like, nigga, you are tainting your legacy. The way we're looking at Floyd Mayweather doing all these exhibition fights and shit like that. Like, dog, I don't know why you're doing this. You don't need the money. You don't need the actual, you feel me, whatever cachet that's going to come out of this. But at the same time, nigga, that nigga's like, yo, my kids can't eat legacy, nigga. And
why
just
not?
Like the nigga said in, nigga, if we really want to get down to it, yes, the fuck they can.
No,
nigga.
No.
Yaya's going to be straight.
I'm saying, why can't Floyd take these exhibitions? Hell yeah,
oh, he can. He can, but they look funny in the light, nigga.
Not really.
They look funny in the light. They look funny in the light. I don't personally care, too. But they look funny in the light because it's a
it
money grab.
Funny
it's definitely a money grab.
And he'll tell you. He said, yeah, this is a robbery. When they told
him, he told them niggas
offered
that straight
me this
the fuck
much,
up.
He said, yep. It's a robbery. I'll do that.
And he said to them, hey, and he said to them verbatim, if y'all don't want to watch,
don't watch. Period. You feel me? So you can't be mad at that. And that's what I was telling people when people, like, I was having this conversation with a few folks, and they were like, well, they're making a mockery of it, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, you can't, I was like, you can't put that on the same level. I was like, if you're going to be mad at, if you're going to be a UFC fighter or a boxer and be mad because these entertainers are stepping in and making it entertaining and collecting a big bag, it might be bigger than you are getting. Yeah, like, granted, you can't be mad. You just got to be more entertaining. That's like a Greek wrestler getting mad at Triple H for being an entertainer, but saying I'm a quote-unquote wrestler and I make 1,000 times more than an actual Olympic gold Greek wrestler.
Big action.
Like they can't be mad. They can't be mad at the people that are providing entertainment. It's like, well, either get into the entertainment field or learn how to sell yourself more.
Floyd Mayweather was at WrestleMania 24.
Yep.
He learned the game.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? And now look at what he's doing and what he just did.
Yeah, he got his own boxing promotion after that. Exactly. And started doing all his own promotion. So he understands how to sell. He understands.
You know how to sell.
So he sees multi-million, almost billion-dollar shit coming in. And he's like, oh, this is all entertainment? That's me. That's me. This don't go on my boxing record.
None of that.
Sign me up. So what if people say? So what if people say I do this, that, and the other, or it make me look funny? I don't care.
Because
I watch Triple H body slam somebody every day over years, and make a living off of it, and he got more money than y'all.
And I say again, you niggas will watch everything wrestling except wrestling. It doesn't make sense to me.
A fucking nut, nigga.
Anyway, last thing that I got before we get the fuck up out of here, and we'll close with this. This week, we've got the upcoming Versus battle. Yes, indeed. We do have Soulja Boy and Bow Wow coming up. But before that, we have the first all-female rap Versus, and it is going to be Eve versus Trina.
Time out. Is that an official flyer?
Yeah, don't tell me that's not official. That it is, but yes.
That's not official. Exactly. Pull that back up.
I don't want to.
I'm going
to
gas that real fast. Pull this back up.
All right. Because, dog, I hate this. Look, these are two women. These are two women that I had extensive time with, enjoying their catalog and also enjoying them as women, and had an amazing crush on these women. That's a horrible Photoshop.
Why did they Photoshop Trina's face on a body?
No, that's Trina.
That's not her.
That's Trina. That's her face. That's her body. That's a picture of Trina. However, then why the Photoshop of face, it looks wild.
Yeah,
it
looks why like does her a, face
it,
look?
It looks like an action figure.
It on.
It looks like an action figure.
And it looks like the hair looks like
you can pull it off. You feel me?
Yeah. And why does Eve have long hair? And then on top of that,
I'm mad because Eve's hair looks horrible. It looks all frizzy. It looks, you feel me? It looks fucked up. It looks crazy. Because Eve has hair, nigga.
If we're talking about
her. Eve has hair.
But she should have her short hair. She should have her picture.
No, she doesn't have to have it. Like, are you just talking about her first album when you talk about her short hair? Because Eve grew her hair out after that.
After she stopped.
Actually, after the second album. By Scorpion, she had started growing her hair out.
Yeah, and she was out of music by then.
No, she was not, nigga. What are you talking about?
Eve was out of music after like her second or third album, dog. All
right.
Dog. And she went straight into it. She had her little TV show. And it was TV show. And then it was no
called,
more.
It was called Eve. Or, what was that TV show called? It was called something, nigga. And her name was not that.
No, she was like a hairstylist or some shit like that.
Yeah, she was. She for sure was.
And then she just disappeared
if the TV show version of Eve was to see this motherfucking Photoshop picture, this flyer, this advertisement, you feel me? The TV version of Eve would be like, what the fuck are you doing? You feel me?
Eve about to smoke Trina.
Oh, kid. You think so?
We about to smoke the boots off of Trina. I'm sorry.
You think so?
Absolutely.
I don't know what's going to happen here. I'm like I said, last time we came in here and was like, da, 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 like the last couple of times we talked about versus battles, I've decided I'm throwing my hands up in the air. I'm not going to be the one to be like, da, 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 this is what's going to happen. Because anytime I pick somebody, it don't happen like that.
It was one of my
first. Don't happen like that.
When I was little. So like, I used to love.
Nigga, I had Eve and Trina on my wall at the same time.
I used to love
both of y'all.
So like, she could never do. But it was her and Maya. Eve and Maya. Those was my.
What's going to happen?
I got an ass so big like the sun. Hope you got a mouth. Want it, you can get it. If you win it, I'ma hit it. Flip it, rub it up, and smack it. Look back at it.
I'm turned red broad in my up all night.
I'm just saying.
Is that even a question?
I'm just saying. I got to ask you. Okay, that's cool.
Is that even a question? You just gotta play the. I'll be like Swiss Beat. Just play the intro of it and cut it off. I was getting mad at Swiss Beats for that too. I was like, nigga, if you don't let something rock, he'd play like the beginning of the hook and then cut it off and be like, yeah. I'm like, nigga, Timbo just played like a whole two verses.
I'm just saying, bro. Like, how do I don't know what happens here.
About that time, y'all. Rough Riders. You don't remember this?
I do remember this. This shit was hard.
Yeah.
This shit was hard.
Yeah. They wanna know. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's dog walking Trina. Like, what's she gonna do when?
Before you do that, nah, you can't play two back to back, nigga. You can't play two back to back, nigga.
I'm not four, nigga.
What's gonna happen?
Okay.
What's gonna happen?
Okay. I might even give you that one.
You gotta give me that.
I might give you that one.
That's a point.
Or
that's a point.
I was on the remix. She was on the remix today. This was big too.
Sucked.
It was a big song though.
That song sucked. Let's be honest. That song sucked. Oh, you want to go Ludacris? You want to go Ludacris?
I know she has.
You want to go Ludacris?
Yeah.
You want to go Ludacris?
All right, yeah. Oh, time out.
You want to go Ludacris, nigga? I feel you. I can't be mad at this.
Nah, it's gonna be a real good battle. They both have some hits. I just feel like Eve has a little bit of a deeper catalog. As far as
Trina's on this. I just want to let you know.
She is on a lot of shit.
Oh, yeah, she got this.
Yeah.
Too. Yeah. I can't play two back to back.
You know, this is good. Yeah,
I don't even know what that was.
She got some features. Hey, Marie, one thing.
Oh, yeah, that too. Back on the track, I thought it was perfect. Oh, nah, let me, fuck that. What's up?
It's
what are you
big.
Talking about? This what are you talking big. About? This was huge, nigga.
Yeah.
What? Stop.
She might have to give her that one and then just, like, take her. No.
You gotta shake your ass.
Hey, Marie, I'm not mad at that. I'm not mad at that.
Yeah. You know, it'll be a good one.
Wait, fuck that. Trina was on this, nigga.
Hey, y'all, we gon' get it right here. This the remix.
What you gonna do? What Chingy said? What you gonna do?
Hey, that's gonna be the one to take Eve out when Chingy drop.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nigga, and nigga Trina's on the My Chick Bad, so nigga, I'll play that right back to back after you play that. I know she is. Why not?
As soon as I played it, I was like, oh yeah, Trina's on this too. But nah, I look forward to that. And the social media. That's a bad, bad bitch.
Nah, that's a bad, bad bitch. Webby and Trina, nigga. You a bad, bad
bitch. You a bad, bad bitch. You a bad, bad bitch. She got some shit. Trina's the baddest and the
thickest bad. Come on now. They got dope shit. Definitely. I want to shout out to Trina. I want to shout out to Eve. I love both of you. Amazing, beautiful women. Oh my God. Making my pole jump early and often as a teenager, a nasty little nigga. You feel me? Y'all deserve all y'all flowers. I don't care who wins. I just want to enjoy the show. And I'm going to enjoy the show. And by the way, I also want to remind you that Trina did this, nigga.
Oh, I know. This is her biggest fucking song. This is damn near a point.
Automatic point. Honestly, that might be Trina's only automatic point.
It depends on where this venue is, too.
I read something about there's something supposed to be like a Versus or something coming up at Essence Fest. So I don't know when Essence Fest is, but if this is that.
No, that's the third one. That's the third one. It's the one.
Okay, so it's this one. It's Soulja and Bow Wow. And then there's the Essence Fest joint.
The Essence Fest.
I feel like that's probably going to be one of like the old school groups or something like that. Like, you feel me? Or something like Adina Howard or something like that. Anita Baker or something. You feel me? Like, or maybe that's when they bust out the. Bam, you feel me? Remember that Mary J. Blige shit that we was teasing, you feel me? Or that we was fake teasing or that y'all figured out and then we was like, all right, let's take that back.
What they gonna do? Mary J. Blige and friends like D'Angelo?
No, Mary J. Blige and Mary J. Blige. Nigga, just this is a Versus presents Mary J. Blige smoking shit, nigga, at Essence Fest. Nigga, what's happening?
And friends.
Ain't no Versus, nigga. Yeah. Can't nobody stand toe-to-toe with Auntie Mary, nigga. What are we talking about?
There's an uncle. That can't nobody stand. Never mind. Yeah, but y'all know where to follow the show. Y'all can follow Twitter at @2BlackSheep_. Y'all can follow Instagram at @2BlackSheep. Y'all know y'all can follow us each individually. I'm at It's Why Are the Gold Mine. He is at
Oh my God, Graham.
Yeah, I was like, it's not it. Oh my God, Graham. Yeah, I mean,
yes, sir.
Y'all need to like, subscribe, hit the notification on the YouTube, tell a friend, tell a girl, to tell a guy, tell your brother, tell a sister, whoever. Like, yeah, I know. Run them likes and subscribes up, y'all. Give us a description. I mean, give us a write us a little.
Give us a rating and a review on Apple Podcasts. I will not and cannot stress how important that is as far as the visibility and the reach of this show. We appreciate y'all beyond measure, but the algorithms, yes, indeed, do run the motherfucking show. So if you can and if you will, run them likes, the subscriptions, you feel me, the tweets, the shares, you feel me, the Apple Music review, all of that shit, run that up for us, you feel me, one time.
Yeah. We might be doing a sweepstakes soon, you know what I mean, be giving away some ick, you know what I mean, so.
Yeah, cool little giveaway or something like that. Why not?
Yeah, y'all got to tap in with us and y'all got to participate. Help participate in, you know what I mean? So we could help pay y'all for participation, you know what I mean? Pay to play. We like that.
Right. Right.
We like that. But y'all already know, this has been episode 76 of the Sensational Sheep Show. You know what I mean? Sensational.
Yeah. My phone just died. I don't have the soundboard anymore.
It's all good. But yeah, it's been real. It's been good. It's been two of them. Go ahead. You can just buy it.
Wait.
Okay, we got what a fire extinguisher, man.
I tell him. Hold on, I say, hey, to all y'all in my DM about a feature, I'm only giving verses for the leakers. Thank I done worked too hard to give verses this hard for niggas who budget that can't cover my sneakers.
And with that, we out.
Yeah.